Hi and welcome. I'm John and this is Unique Wargaming Terrain. Guys, this is the weekly painting video. So those of you new to the channel or just come across the channel, sit back and enjoy. In this video, I paint through my pile of shame. There's some things, like especially a few things in this video, you're like, oh, how's that pile of shame? But they're in the pile of shame, so they're getting done. Regulars here, guys. I feel the love. Thank you very much. So what are we getting on this week? Well, this week's terrain build, if you haven't seen part one of the Insane Wizards Tower, go back and have a look at that, guys. But what I'm painting this week, I say painting, first of all, this guy's going to get a... This is going to be the protagonist, is that the correct word? The bad guy, okay? This is going to be the main bad guy that's in the tower. Now, these guys, okay, they're going to be the ones that are sent to sort him out. Now, as you can see, those ones are already painted. Yeah, but they're not. I painted these a long time ago. These are from the old Talisman game. So what I'm going to do is just, my painting skills really improved since then. So I'm just going to tidy these up and give this guy a paint. So guys, sit back, watch, enjoy. I'll see you in a minute. Guys. So hopefully this week I don't do knocky camera as I did last week. I kept knocking the camera in the weekly Wednesday. I think that was stupid. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get some shimmery skull onto my wet palette. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to do all these. Anything that I'm going to wash down with to make like bone or skulls or anything like that. I'm going to give it some screaming skull. Shine gently. Just dry brush the face. At this point, it doesn't matter if I get the screaming skull on any clothes or anything like that, because I can tidy up afterwards. So we get the light colour on. Hands, because his hands are semi-exposed. Let's get them. Now, this Jade Wizard, as you can see, the greens are very flat and very, you know, there's no, this is so detailed, it's just very flat. I think the best thing to do with this guy is maybe start off with a brown or some description. So I'll go organ and flesh. Actually, virgin caramel shade. So paintbrush in my mouth and mumbling away. Virgin camo shade, I think I'm gonna wash him down with a little bit. Just to try and get dirty off that green a little bit. I think as that dries off, that's going to give me a much better look straight away. Okay. The light wizard. This one's so bad. Let's see, I'm going to give him some of the same just on the here because it seems a bit. Again, it's all flat. I can just wash it down a bit. It might give it a little bit more. I decided to give the cloak a little wash down because I can dry brush it afterwards with a light colour and it'll just, it should really pop really well. Some of you are going to say, dry brushing after washing? Interesting. But yeah, yeah, you can. You can do that nicely. I'll do his armour and his hands, darken it all down. That's me in my infinite youth. Decided I was going to just flat base colour it. It's a vast improvement already. Maybe I should do that across the Devil Wizard as well. Especially on those yellow feathers on his head. Oh my goodness me. What the hell was I thinking? Dirty down this closing bit. And that hat, oh my goodness me. Already this is a vast improvement. Just a wash. Ironically, I think I've sort of sussed out the way the lights should work be, and just the way I've got them now. So again, guys, you know, when you're watching this, if you think, oh, actually, that's good, but you could do it like this or do it like that, just come below and let me know. Because I'm just learning to do with lighting with models and stuff like that. So but I'm going to give that a minute to dry and then decide what colour I'm going to do this guy. So see you soon, guys. Right. I'm going to try something really outrageous and really experimental on my guy. I'm going to go Genesis the Purple, first of all. Just on the back palette, a bit easy to work with. And this is a layer paint, so it will go on. So a couple of layers it goes on. Why is it coming out like that? I don't know. And let that first little bit of layer paint dry. I think my brush was too wet, but it doesn't matter. Because that's the beauty of a layer paint. So that's come out and you see bits of black coming through and it doesn't look that great. And because of the layer paint, when I start adding the second bit to it, it blends in nicely. I'm not doing that now, I'm just tidying out a little bit up there. Now I'm going to go with a Rebuta armor. Yeah. I get his chest piece here. I think I got the water pot in the wrong position because I have it over here. Every time I put my hand over it, it's a bit with the light. No, right. Are you dry yet? Almost. We're going to go with you. Let's get some brown in there. I'm going to go with some Bane Blade Brown on the Jade Wizard. Now, I'm not painting this on. This is going to be a simple dry brush. Okay, namely, what's his beard, his hair, they're just, they're black with bits of green on them. It's not very, I don't know what the hell I was thinking when I was younger, but you do these things when you're young, don't you? And this Bane Blade Brown is actually a layer paint. So as I'm painting it on, it goes on bright and it starts dulling down. So you can always add more and more and more to it. That's his beard. I don't want to do that on these clothes now, so I'm going to go for a different type of brown. I'm actually going to go for some still leading drab. And this is a base paint. I'm not base painting it, I'm going to do a dry brush. Well, not really a dry brush, I'm just, I don't know what it's called, I'm just, see how I'm getting in between the little bits just to dull it down a bit. In the sleeves, I'm sort of trying to go between where the edges are and any like little nooks in the clothing. See, like the crease in there, I don't want to get that, I want to leave that as it is. Now I'm going to go a little dry brush in the beard. The reason why separates the hair from the beard, stops it all looking the same. And I'm just touching the side of his face, the side of his hair there with it, but just to really make it stand out a little bit more. Okay, hopefully that's not too much out of focus. Well, I hope he's not out of focus at all, but no, my luck. Right, onto the light wizard. Let's really dull that down nice, that looks good. The copper in that looks good. His face needs tidying up. His face is terrible. So I think I'm going to go with some Screaming Skull. So down here already. And I'm going to dry brush his face. And a little dry brush. Side it up a little bit. Now. I should dry brush this now. Now this is the wash on here, still slightly wet, which is good. There's some dry brushing it, it's actually just moving it around. See, I'm just dry brushing the cloak now with that Screaming Skull. Yeah, some of you are going to say, oh, John, but the seal still is wet. I want it, that's what I want. I want to be able to flick into it. Just see that? Just take it away from it. Edge as well. Top of the snake's helmet. I brush his beard. You're just going dry brush mail on this guy. This guy's skull now. Now when I paint skulls, I try and dry brush it with the Screaming Skull. Everyone does skulls differently, but this is the way that I do it. Just sort of dry brush it with the Screaming Skull. And the back of the head, make sure you get a lot of it. You know, not a dry brush on the back, but a bit more of a solid colour. I think this guy's going to get a dry brush as well, but it's still wet in the beard and I don't want to mess that up. Let's get the cloak. especially with this model. I think the staff there, I think it's had too much paint on it, so I think it's lost the detail of the grain. It's not, you know, I can't do nothing about that, I'm afraid. The purple's coming out nice. Let's give it a second coat. On this second coat now, I'm following it down the robes, okay? I want to try and go with all the grooves and the twists and the, you know, any little bumps and grumps on that on the robes itself. I want to go with. I'm going to dry for a second. I'll see you in a second, guys. Right. I'm going to try this niblet green. Your manager shop said to me it's a dry brush, but it comes out really thick. But it goes on really nice. So I'm going to try that on the Jade Wizard. Didn't have any moot green when I was there. What am I going to go for? Let's try and blend this in a little bit. Yeah, I'm not don't like this colour so far, so yeah, it is a bit. Actually, it's coming off now, it's starting to look good. Blend all those edges in. Again, same with this staff. And the hand stick or the handle, I think there's too much paint on it and the wood grain's gone. I'll try my best and get some of it up, but I don't think it's going to come up. I'm just going to add a little bit of this into the hair. It's an okay colour. It's the first time using a dry paint. Not really impressed with it, to be honest with you. You know, if I'm using it wrong, guys, then just come below, let me know. I don't really... Let me see if I can show you that. That's how it looks. Can you see that? There's no flow to it at all. It looks like the paint's been left in there too long. You know, like when you have that and you open a pot and it's like, oh, it's all like pasty and you have to just add a little bit of water to it and just mix up a little bit. Right, actually, I'm also going to try this. Experiment in time. This is, Ogron camo. Now this is an airbrush paint, so it's going to be very watery, but I'm going to use it to dry brush. That shouldn't be too bad. A bit more colour to it. What happened? There's been a funny green colour. Not too sure about that one either. Ogron camo. I think it'd be good in some certain circumstances, but I just don't. For me on there, it's not that great. Now, where am I going to go with this? I'm going to go with this one. Oh yeah, white scar. I'm going to go for Mr. Man now. When it comes to the skulls now, I just dry brush it with the white. Okay. Especially across the eye sockets and all that business. Now the back of the head, I just try and give it a nice solid wipe. I don't do the whole thing, because I want it to have a bit of the black coming through, and a bit of the screaming skull. I actually like this colour. This layer of white scars is actually brilliant. It's a white, but it's like a layer paint as well, so it gives you the benefit of just really, you know, to get in there and dry brush nice. Now, I like that colour. That's a good colour. It's the best white I've ever used. Right, let's go with some. We're going to go with some U. Chainmail. Is there anything left in there? come on. This is another little technique you see me doing right now. When you're painting like something circular, like a spear or something like that, if you do it from side to side, most people try and paint it around or paint it down. If you just paint from side to side, like this, like as if you're dry brushing it, but you've got more paint on the brush than the, you know, you need a dry brush. What's going to happen is you're going to get most of it on there, but there's going to be a few little streaks coming through with the underneath and give it like a worn effect. notice I was slightly off camera. I apologise. You get so into it, I forget how I'm actually filming. Well, someone says, yeah, but you keep talking. I always talk to myself when I'm painting or doing, you know. That's part of the reason why I started the YouTube channel in the first place, because of COVID, I couldn't have no one over at the workshop to buy anything. So I said, you know what? I sit and talk to myself when I make stuff anyway, so why not just film it and just, you know, be done with it. Right, I'm going to try this absolutely insane idea. Yes, I am. I'm going Emperor's Children. It's like a pink. So again, it's a layer paint. Some on the brush. And I'm literally going to go from the edge here. Start bringing it up. See that pink there, it's just really just taking the harshness of that purple away, isn't it? Instantly, like, temperature drop in the... Sorry, done again. It's instant, the temperature drop in the purple paint. Get out of my way if I knock you over. I'm going and pushing the button over you guys and going for it. Let's go with a... No. Let's go with a corn red. And we are going for in here. I actually have two others of this same model. Because they're chaos sorcerers, aren't they? So I said, I'll get one for each of the chaos powers that have magic that can use wizards. So I actually have another three of these. To be honest with you, they're actually not that bad to paint. They're actually pretty straightforward and pretty easy. I'm just going to give that a moment to dry and then I'll be right back to you. Okay. I've just realized I'm on 55 minutes, guys. Shit, I didn't realize it was that much. Anyway, that's not a problem because there's four models here. Three that I've tidied up and one that I'm, you know, working on. I started painting and I forgot to press record. That's when I looked at it and saw the time. So I've painted Rhinox hide on the stone bits here. Okay. That's all I've done. Off camera, and I was like, oh no, let me record. Right, so now I'm going to go for a Esmond Blue Wash. Okay. Now, some of you may not be able to have this anymore. They don't sell it no more, I'm not sure. But if you can't and you want to use a blue wash again, just get a blue paint that you want and wash it down, like wear it really wear down. This is where we're going to go. It's the face and the horns. And the arm. What I'm trying to do now is just push the blue wash away from the eyes. Okay. By doing this, it should get the effect of his eyes are glowing. Well, that's the effect I'm going for anyway. Because of the white underneath. Don't know if you can make that out at all. Not too far away. So now I'm going to go again. I'm really going to push the boundary to this painting. I'm going to go with Lothlorien blue layer paint. What I'm going to do is try and get into them eyes. Am I on focus? Yeah, I am. can. Can you make that demise out? Oh yeah. There's a little bit more in it. I need something behind here really, don't I? To back. Nice. Now what I'm going to do. A little bit of a dry brush. Now with what I'm doing here, it's going to take away any little bits down here that look rubbish. Okay, I just adding that bit of blue, just disguise everything, any mistakes that I've made that I can see and go, oh, I don't like that, rather than me having to spend time and try and mess around and tidy it up. Next, I'm going to go with a, not lock the camera, Baneblade Brown, and I'm actually looking to dry brush. These bad boys. Baneblade Brown again is a layer paint. It goes on nice and bright and dials down. That's what you want. Let's see what I'm doing there. I don't know. The birds are starting to wake up. How does that look? The base I'm talking about now. It's just two colours. Well, three colours actually. Baneblade Brown, sorry. Binox Hide to the stone. Corn Red to do the bits in between the stone. And then Baneblade Brown, which is layer paint over the top of it. Now what's needed? Some Ophosian camo shade. I'm gonna wash the armor down, give it a bit of a dirty look. I know there are going to be people that look at this and go, oh, I'm not watching it, it's an hour long. No, no, no. And there are going to be other people that go, oh, yes, John, thank you at last. Let me just chuck, let me get my paints ready and start doing some painting whilst you're, you know. If you're one of these people that don't like long videos, I apologise, guys. It's never my intention to make long, long videos. If you are one of these guys that love long videos, then, you know, enjoy. Don't tell me that's what it's been doing the whole time. Been focusing up on something else. Oh, yes, shit. There it has, guys. I do apologise. Anyway, if you've watched this video and liked this video, please like, share, subscribe. Turn on your notifications. And these are all designed for this week's terrain build. Okay? So, this is this week's terrain build, guys. It's nowhere finished yet, so the sun's beaming right off of the... Okay, see how crazy that is?